So here we are with Hey Email, and it is a very interesting application, and you may be looking at it to establish whether it's worth the $99 a year and whether it's worth you actually all of the upheaval to move into an application like this. Now, for very simple terms, Hey wants to help you to organize your calendar and your email, which it combines into one application. And it does that with some unique and opinionated ways of structuring your email. It almost retrains you in how you think about email. So we're going to give you an overview of it. Let's start with some of the basics, because this application is available on iOS, Android, web, Mac, and on Windows as well. You can also, I believe, get a snap version of this, which I think means you can get on Linux. So as you can see, this is what you're met with when you enter the account. And one of the first things to note is you're probably wondering, how do I go about doing the forwarding element of this? Because obviously, when you start a Hey email account, you get a .hey email address, which obviously restarts your email, essentially. But there's something called forwarding, where you can set up a email address, whatever that is, and basically forward things into here, which is helpful. So that's one of the things that you can do straight away. You can't, I believe, email from that email address. But at the same time, if you're transitioning over to it, it's really, really helpful. Now, one of the things they did state, which was quite helpful, is when you go into this forwarding area and connect it up, if Hey Email in the future were to just die, which, you know, you can never predict these sort of things, but I know Basecamp 37 Signals as a company is very robust and lean, then they will forward that on forever, which is pretty generous. So that's, again, a promise that they'll make. So obviously that doesn't mean if the whole company is discontinued, it means if the product is just discontinued, but I know that they have a good set of users, which is good news. So that's how to set things up, and you get a Hey email. I got Francesco D, but obviously you might, the more and more users there are, the less and less chance you're likely to get your one. So this is the main area you're met with called the inbox, and the inbox essentially does a few things. It puts important emails there, but it also screens people before they email you. So for example, in this case, you can approve people that come into your system. So for example, any emails from founders at estripe.com, you can say yes. You can also define it into specific categories like the feed, paper trail. Now, paper trail is where your receipts go, things that are paper-based. You know what I mean? Like things that are more static, like documents or files or maybe receipts. But the feed is probably best suited for this one. So you don't actually have to force yourself into structuring it the way that you do, which is quite helpful. And you can also clear them all if you want to. Now in this right-hand corner, you do have the ability to have a speakeasy code, which basically allows people to get straight into your inbox and it bumps it up. So if they add that to the subject line, it will automatically add that. Now that's a very detailed feature. And something to use if you know somebody and you're probably a bit more high profile than me. So if you go to done, you can go to inbox, and up in the top right hand corner, you can create an email. And it's very simple in terms of its structure. You can schedule it and you can bubble it up, which is something that basically comes back later. You can add attachments as if you were doing normal email, and you can see any drafts you've got, as well as add things to the BCC, etc. Your pretty regular email experience. There's obviously some just basic formatting in there, which will work well. So down here, you probably notice there are two things. There's this, which is called, focus and reply. And this is a good area if you're like, got a bunch of emails that you need to reply to, but you want to stack them for later. This is sort of like a way to just funnel them and start replying to them, which is quite nice. So you can reply here, send them, reply, send them, and sort of go down the list. The other one down here is set aside. This is an area where these are emails to set aside, and you can drag items into there at any given time. So that's really helpful for organizing what the items need to do. In any given time, you can add these to set aside. For example, that was set aside, and that was can be reply later. But there are a bunch of other abilities. You can add labels, collections, and even add a note to them as well. And there is a workflow ability, which we'll come to a bit later. So if anything, these are updates for the journal ability, I can move that to the feed. You're probably wondering, where is everything? Well, essentially, it's tucked away in this menu up here, but you can access it by pressing 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And let's show you the feed and paper tray. The feed is essentially just a way, like a newspaper's type of structure, which is really helpful. And paper trail is for those emails that come up. Now, what's really nice as well is this is trying to teach you more effective emails. Important emails come in here, stuff that needs to be set aside for later come in here, and stuff that you need to only come to regularly come in here. And there are a bunch of other functions that help narrow down your inbox. And you're probably wondering, this might be overload, but the more and more you train your Hey email, the more likely it's going to start putting it things in the right place over time. So you can see your sent emails here, your contacts here, and you can see your, it's like a blog type feature called Hey World. And this is that bubble up feature. The bubble up feature is essentially a way to snooze an email. So if I bubbled up this feature, then what it's going to do is come back at 6 p.m. tonight, but it will remove it from the inbox, which is quite good. But it comes back into the inbox, which is helpful. And I can access that any given time by going to the bubble up area. And I can also bubble everything now, so it returns to its original spot. Now, what's cool is you can manage all of your collections down here if you've got a type of email that you want to bring in. And if I go back here, all of those options are still available to me, and you can also mark it as seen as well. Now, what does it look like inside an email? Well, essentially, everything can be accessed here. You can learn these, you can bubble it up, you can set it aside, you can reply now, and there's some more options as well to adding labels. Now, just something to note, it's slightly laggy, and that's not my fault. My wife is, I think, on a video call right now. So you can see that this slightly slower in comparison if that's something you're worrying about. I haven't actually had an issue with it so far. Now, there's two things you can do inside of here. You can actually click in and rename your email subject. This is really helpful. So the other person won't see it. So if you want to call this one, I hate Spear, as an example, then it won't show in the other person's inbox. But it is a better way to organize if you've got a project or something like that. There's also up here, for example, this is a tracker, a convert fit is added to it. This blocks your tracker. So essentially it indicates that you're protected from the spyware or spy trackers, the opening abilities and things like that, that some email providers have. So obviously this is a really smart way to organize stuff. You can pop stuff open if you want to. And you can start managing it from there. Now up here, you can, I think I talked about these other ones, you can screen people out, but you can access them. You can see all files that have been sent to you and everything at a glance, and still access all the regular stuff like spam. So this concept is very unique. It's different. It's not meant to be like regular email. It's meant to train you so that you focus on the important stuff and clear the other stuff later. Bit like labels do in Gmail, but probably a lot more intense. And up in the top right hand corner, you can change things like appearance as well as screening history, just into light and dark mode as well. Now, the other magic is where you can access the calendar abilities, and this is accessible here. Now, the calendar is very different. You can go sideways with your calendar, which means that it shows sideways as a sort of horizontal timeline of the day. You can add items, you can do countdowns, you can do circle events, which helps to indicate an event coming up. But what I like most about it is the week view. The week view is a really attractive view. You can start to see your week ahead, and you can even add habits up here as well. So for example, this could be I go and work out, and you can tick these on and off, which is helpful. You can also skip ahead, create an event, and if you were to create an event, it's really dead simple to start adding some details to it. You can also change it to be a public event as well, which is quite cool. And you can also add items down here. For example, you know, you could add things like a walk and drag it into and add it to your system just by organizing it there. So you can also have a maybe event, which is quite cool. So it sort of updates it, so it's a bit more like sort of blurred out. It could be an event, it could not be an event, which is helpful. And up here, you'll be able to see three additional things. You can add your calendar, which is quite nice. So if you want to add an external calendar, pretty helpful. You can also add time tracking, which means that you can track a set amount of time that you've worked on something. You can see your habits. Creating a new habit is really easy. And it means that you can quickly access it at the top of your menu, which means you can keep the streak going for certain things. And there's a new feature called journal. So if you want to add your journal entries in here, that's quite cool. it's almost like email, Hey Email and Hey Calendar are going to add a third experience like Hey Notes, and I can imagine that being an all-in-one system. But the calendar is really helpful because you can get an ICS feed, which is quite helpful, and you can share it with an additional Hey user if they have an account, which means that they can collaborate on it in real time as well. So what other functions do this ability have? Now, you can add an event here, for example, and you can add notes to it. You can circle the event and you can repeat it. So you can have regular stuff. And the circle just indicates a circle around it, which is quite cool. You can also have something like, say I had an all-day event for vacation. Well, I can add a countdown to it and add this event. So I can have when the item comes, but I'm going to have this as a general because it's much more important. I'm going to circle it and press update. And you can see that this vacation is coming up. Now, what's nice is you can add images, I believe. I can't remember how you do that, but you can do that, which is good news. You can also add notes to it as well, just light notes, add a link to it, add invitees, add a location. Maybe if I add the location, it will populate it, and I'll update the information. So that's really neat in terms of being able to create something. Here, if I go to the day area, maybe that changes it. No, but you can start to see that the details come in like here, and the 7 days vacation and the journal entry can be all updated from here. So that's quite nice. So in terms of its operation, really, really helpful in terms of getting started. You can also add important dates like vacation starts over the top of things as well, which is a nice little hack. So you're probably wondering, should I invest in this? Should I go for Hey Email? Because it's a big shift. And this one is going to take you, it's a big commitment to move over to a new email application, especially one that changes the way that you're doing something. It sort of also feels like you're starting a new domain as well, because you're going to have to train people to come over to this, even though you've got the forwarding set up. And you're also going to be emailing from a new inbox. So this one is going to be a big commit. But at the same time, it's got some powerful features as part of it. Some features are going to change your productivity, refocus your attention, and also train your inbox to be smarter. But also, you've got a calendar ability, which is really nice and works very well. Having habits, time tracking, and journal in there all in one is a pretty decent offering. And for $99 a year with your own domain and all of these features, I think it's fairly reasonable. I think that's actually a good bet in terms of its pricing. It's mid-range pricing these days if you compare it to other apps like Superhuman, which over the course of 3 months is going to charge you the same amount as this yearly pricing does. So hopefully this was helpful in overviewing. They're from a really credible company, 37 Signals, so obviously you're going to get that credibility there. And they constantly add features, which is good news. Here's the last one that they added. You can actually improve your email threads as well. So they're constantly developing features on a sort of 2 to 3 month cycle, which is pretty good in terms of what they're offering. So hopefully that gave you the good idea of whether Hey is good for you. And if you have any questions, let us know. You can find us over on toolfinder.co if you're exploring more email apps.